Good morning. Hi, Isla. Hi, Elijah.
Oh, look how
pretty. How was Santa last night?
Was it fun meeting Santa?
Yeah.
Yay! I was thinking about you. I'm glad to see you this morning. I'm glad you got to meet him. Good. So can you say that a little bit louder? Oh, how fun. It's so special. It was a wonderful way to use your Friday night for sure.
And yesterday we played on a motorcycle.
Oh, nice. Good for you. I noticed the sun is shining at my house today, but I can see at your house the sun is shining so brightly behind you. Such a beautiful Saturday we're having. And old Jack Frost painted my yard last night, so it's all white. It's like my Christmas tree is white, but that's just artificial. But out in my yard, it's all white. So it's starting to feel wintery and Christmassy out there for sure.
Me too. It's feeling white out my
yard. You have that too? We must live close to each other.
On TV.
So we're
watching football.
Yeah. Thank the Lord we can still watch football. There's a lot of things we can't do, but the football games are on.
Yep.
You got bubbles. And I got.
So we're going to just kind of visit together for a couple of minutes. I'm going to see more kids. But Mr. Ben, he's my helper. We actually have three different cameras. So some kids are watching. I don't know their names because I can't see them. So see if I can see them. Okay. Well, I think we'll go ahead and get started. And you guys can actually let me know if it's getting to be too long. We can always finish one of the stories next week, but we're going to do story time again next week at 8 o'clock in the evening on Tuesday and again on Thursday. And I've got quite a few Christmas books. Last week, my younger girls, they were excited that we were going to do Angelina Ballerina. And if you can believe it, I can't find the book right now. So I'm thinking I had to left it over at the dance studio. But the girls who were interested, they ended up not logging on. So maybe we'll do Angelina later in the week. But one of the books I'm going to read today, it's called Olivia and the Christmas Present. And that's kind of neat because our dance teacher who's teaching ballet in the other studio right now, her name is Olivia. So I'm thinking I might kind of tease her and I'll tell her that we were reading a book all about her today. In this story, Olivia is a cute little piglet and she has a little brother. And we're playing with the lighting here. It makes it really bright for me, but then I have to wear my sunglasses and I can't see it anymore. Okay, so let's go ahead and get started. And if people are watching Facebook Live or any other platforms, I'm so glad you're here. And I apologize, I can't greet you personally, but I know that I've got Elijah and Isla over on Zoom. So if I see any more of my students logging on, we'll make sure we greet them. Olivia and the Christmas Present. Oh, and also, everybody, I want to mention, anytime during the story, if you want to send a little message in the chat box or make comments, feel free, because we love to have interaction. I might not be able to answer everybody right away, but all the events are recorded, so I could even kind of maybe text you back later on if we don't get to it during this time, but feel free to put comments in. If your family has any special Christmas traditions that you do, or there's a special present you want to talk to us about, I'd love to hear some of the things that your families do for Christmas. Okay. Olivia and the Christmas Present. It was the night before Christmas, and Olivia had something very important, top secret, that she needed to take care of. She crept quietly past her mom and dad, who were singing Christmas carols. Deck the halls with balls of holly. La 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 la. They were singing loudly. Olivia quickly headed upstairs with Perry, following not far behind. So you can see mom and dad Piglet, they're singing songs. We see the staircase where Olivia is sneaking upstairs because she has some top secret Christmas missions she needs to take care of. Perry, there's no food in here, Olivia explained as she set the big pot on her bed. But what's inside is even better. So she was being sneaky. She had a pot from the kitchen and there's something secret inside there. Perry is her dog and he wants to be involved in everything. And I know that Isla and Alleged, you guys have dogs and you can't see on the camera, but Mr. Asher, he's actually laying right here on his Christmas blanket beside me. So he's like Perry the dog. Olivia says, now, to wrap it up, she had to go rummaging through the Christmas paper. Perry, bark if you hear Ian coming. So in this part of the picture, her dog Perry is helping her on her secret mission. Ian is her brother, and Perry's gonna be going roof, 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 if he hears or sees anything suspicious, because that's going to help Olivia to finish her mission without being caught. With the present perfectly wrapped, Olivia made a place for it under the Christmas tree. Ian, she cried as she spotted her brother hiding behind the tree. Are you peeking at your presents? No, yes, maybe, Ian replied. No peeking. You'll ruin the surprise, Olivia exclaimed. But I'm such a good guesser, Ian said. Olivia knew that Ian was right. He was the best present guesser she'd ever met. But Olivia also knew that she couldn't let Ian guess this present. It had to be kept a surprise. So here in the picture, we can see that there's a Christmas tree. The brother was hiding behind the tree, being so sneaky. But Olivia did a very good job of wrapping the present. She's pretty sure her brother will never, ever, ever guess what it is, because she kind of camouflaged it in a different shape. What is it? Ian asked as he lunged for the present. Olivia dashed away to her room and slammed the door before Ian could follow her in. After a moment, Olivia slowly opened the door to check the hallway to see if it was clear. And there was Ian. So, what did you get me? He insisted. Olivia slammed the door again. I'm going to need a good hiding place for this present, Olivia said to herself. She decided to ask Francine for help. Hey, Francine, she called out. Before Olivia could finish her sentence, Francine appeared by her side. I need a good hiding place for Ian's present, Olivia finished. We should hide it in a place that Ian never goes, Francine suggested. Olivia smiled. She had the perfect place in mind. So here there's four different scenes, and Francine is Olivia's very good friend that lives close, so she called out and she was there immediately. So now the two friends are being very sneaky. They're trying to think of a place that Ian never goes. Ian's laundry, Olivia explained as she pointed to the hamper in the bathroom. He never even goes near the dirty laundry hamper. Problem solved, Francine said. Seconds later, Mom came in the bathroom. Hi, girls, she said as she scooped up the clothes from the hamper. I'm just going to run one more load of laundry before Christmas. The present! Olivia and Francine cried. Well, isn't that the way it goes sometimes, guys? The minute the girls thought they found the perfect hiding place, Mom decides to do the laundry. What mom even does the laundry on Christmas Eve? I don't know. So now the girls are sad and they're a little distraught. Distraught means they're worried. Whew. That was close, Francine said. The present safely back in her hands, Olivia tried to think of another hiding place.
There was no safe place to hide the present inside the house, Francine said. You're right, exclaimed Olivia. There's just one thing to do. We'll go outside. Outside, Olivia and Francine found the perfect hiding place under a red bucket. No one will ever find the present here, Olivia said. Great, I'm gonna go home now and hang my stocking, Francine said as she waved goodbye. Merry Christmas, Olivia. Merry Christmas, Francine, Olivia replied. Thank you so much for your help. Now, this is interesting to me in the picture. It's Christmas Eve, but everything is green. So I'm wondering if Olivia actually lives in Seattle, because here in the Pacific Northwest, it's green at Christmas time. But if you live in Colorado or Kansas City or Indianapolis or places east of here, it's usually white on the bottom. So they found a red bucket. They hid the present inside the red bucket out on the grass in the backyard. Hopefully Ian will not go out there. The next morning, Olivia woke up and she was thinking about one thing and only one thing. It's Christmas, she cried. She was racing through the yard and into the backyard. It's time for me to get Ian's Christmas surprise. Surprise? Olivia gasped. As she looked outside, she saw snow. She was not expecting it. There was snow everywhere. Come on, Perry, she called as she grabbed a shovel. We've got to dig and find Ian's present. Now the good news is dogs are good diggers. My dog loves to dig, and even though we don't have snow, he likes to dig in the backyard and try to find a mole, or I don't even know what he's looking for. But I'm sure that Perry is gonna be a very good helper for digging. Olivia and Perry began to dig, looking for the red bucket with Ian's gift inside. Perry found something red, but it was a bicycle. Keep digging, Olivia instructed. But it was no use. There was just too much snow. I'd have to be a machine to get rid of all this snow, Olivia said to herself. I wonder. So let you look at the picture for a minute. But Olivia's thinking of what she might try next. Olivia imagined what it would be like to be a flying robot. Ian, I think you like robots, so you probably would have thought of that also. If she were a robot with powerful jets of air coming out of her feet, time for some super duper snow blowing, declares Olivia as she began to clear the yard. Ta-da! Olivia knew what to do. She turned to Perry. Snowblower, she told herself. So she wasn't a robot, but she was thinking something like a snowblower is like a robot. So I like how my kids and my students have really good imaginations, and I do too. When you're into dance and performing arts, usually we're very creative and we can come up with great solutions. So I bet that Olivia was actually a dancer, that she thought of the robot and the snowblower. Soon, Olivia had made her very own snowblower. Snow was flying everywhere. It's working, Olivia shouted. Olivia pedaled harder and harder and whoosh! The wind from Olivia's snowblower blew snow off the top of the red bucket. Whoosh! Another gust and the wind tipped the red bucket over. Ian's present, Olivia cried happily. Inside the house, Ian was already looking at the presents under the tree. Well, of course he was, because we know he's sneaky and we know he's the best present guesser. So there he was under the tree. Ian yelled when he saw Olivia. Merry Christmas, Ian, Olivia said as she handed him the present. I don't know how you did it, Olivia, but this is a surprise, said Ian. Poco Loco Penguin, Ian cried as he unwrapped his present. This is the best present in the history of history. Ian gave Poco Loco Penguin a big squeeze. So there's the picture. And that penguin must be Ian's favorite animal and his favorite toy. And I think that the animal tells little jokes, because what happened next was Ian squeezed the toy and he said, "What is a skunk's favorite sandwich?" It asked. "Peanut butter and smelly." Ian started laughing and he gave his sister a big hug. And Olivia beamed. She was so happy that she was able to keep the surprise from Ian. It's the end of the day. It's time for bed. Mama is tucking Olivia into bed. "So, Santa did a good job this year?" Olivia's mom asked later in the evening. "The best," said Olivia. "I love all my presents, but my favorite gift was the one that I surprised Ian with." "I'm not surprised," Mother said. "It was a wonderful gift from a wonderful girl." It was time for bed, but Olivia didn't want to go to sleep just yet. "Good night, Olivia, and Merry Christmas." "Good night, Mom and Dad." And there's the picture of Olivia being tucked in. And I want to ask you a question. You can either send me a little email or a text, or you can put something in the chat box or make a comment on Facebook. I want to hear what would make your Christmas really, really special. And Olivia was such a sweet girl because she was more excited about giving a present and hiding it from her brother than even her own presents. And I think sometimes it's that way, the idea that it's better to give than to receive. And of course, we all love to receive presents, but it's so neat to give presents also. So you can send me a little comment and I'd love to hear of a present that you gave to someone or anything that has to do with giving and sharing love in this season. So we're gonna do this again on Tuesday at 8 o'clock, and we'll do it next Thursday at 8 o'clock. Today I have on my Santa hat and I wore my Christmas pajamas, and Asher's here, he's laying down on his Christmas blanket, but I'm gonna change the scene. I'll have a different costume for Tuesday and a new book. So you can let your friends know if you're watching us on Facebook Live. It is a free event, so just kind of invite people in. And please do comment. We're kind of figuring it out also. So if there was a bad camera angle or you couldn't hear very well, we'd love to know, because we want to do better for you next time. So have a wonderful Saturday. Enjoy the frost. If you're watching us from out of state, you probably do have snow. And if you're here in Seattle, have a green day. And see you again soon. And Isla and Elijah, I'll see you in acro class next Friday too.